Chancellors! Welcome to a new episode of the Developer Diaries. I hope you guys are excited for what's waiting for this month's content. And without further ado, let's dive straight into the agenda. For today's agenda, we're going to take a look at the character and event information. And obviously, as usual, the update information. And to close things out, we're going to take a look at the outfit design contest winner, which will receive an in-game illustration based on their design. So I hope you guys are excited to see how this one turned out. And here we have the character art for our latest characters. Tengu versus Snake, a duel for love. Ooh, very exciting. We see our new character called Momiji together with Benimaru. And I wonder who the snake is referencing to. I have some ideas. But without further ado, let's dive into the character information. And here we have her, Momiji the Tengu Elder's proxy. It's a battle type character and she's a fire type character, part of the forces, Ogre's Pride, Heart of Devotion, and Commander. Her first skill increases all allies' pierce rate and increases own fire attack. Her second skill increases all allies' synergy rate and decreases all targets' synergy rate resistance. Momiji's secret skill unleashes an all-target fire magic attack for normal damage and decreases all targets' defense. And as usual, you can perform an EX ultimate when you have two bars filled. Now let's take a look at Momiji's secret skill video. Kazuyo, odore. Tsuranari shibuki wa ima arashi to naru. Ogorori wo kouyō no mai. Nanda, taishita koto nai no ne. Benimaru, the heaven-soaring oni, is a protection type character and he's effective against earth type enemies. His protection skill increases Souls of Combo damage until the end of battle, and it also increases the Soul of Divine Protection skill point increase until the end of battle. And when the skill is awakened, it increases all allies' pierce power after 8 turns from the start of battle. His Divine Protection increases damage done by Ogre's Pride Force characters to Earth Attribute enemies and increases Magic characters' attack and defense. At the beginning of each turn, from turn 2 onward, increases the skill cost limit until the end of battle. Let's take a look at Benimaru's Divine Protection video. Hakuro, the Blade Master Oni, is a battle type character. He's a wind type character, part of the forces, Ogre's Pride, Tempest Elite, and Flashback Beatdown Emissary. His first skill changes Ogre Pride Force character Souls into Souls of Divine Protection, blue, and increases all Souls of Divine Protection gauge increase. His second skill increases Ogre's Pride Force character's secret skill gauge and increases the Soul of Divine Protection damage until the end of battle. Hakura's secret skill unleashes a single target wind magic attack for normal damage and decreases all targets' guard power. Now let's take a look at his secret skill video. And we guessed it, the snake. Alba's Divine Wife is a protection type character and is effective against earth enemies. Her protection skill increases Soul of Combo damage until the end of battle and increases the skill cost limit until the end of battle. Additionally, it also increases the Souls of Divine Protection skill point increase until the end of battle. Her Divine Protection increases damage done by magic characters to earth attribute enemies and increases fire characters' attack. Well, let's take a look at the full character lineup. And here we have the Tengu vs. Snake Duel for Love character lineup. They are part of the charge type. Momiji and Benimaru are the recruitable characters, and players will receive Albus from the bingo missions as the free-to-play protector. And Hakuro is received from the event, and you can level up by receiving duplicates from his beatdown battle. Let's move on to the content and update overview. and we're starting off with some content updates that already happened. So for the people who didn't know, the update that was recently released on the 23rd added improvements to the limited mission screen, where missions are now organized per event, so we hope this helps people easily find the limited time missions. But that is not all, we also added a camera rotation function on the nation builder screen. And this should help you build more easily or see more easily which buildings you have built by being able to rotate by clicking on the camera button. And for more information about the content and update information, we have more voice lines coming during battles, which will be added on the 29th. Then we have more things coming soon without a date just yet, but Heroes Jubilee will be receiving a update. Whatever that means will be revealed later. And something will be happening in the tourism district. What can it be? Definitely make sure you don't miss it and keep an eye out on our social media channels. For the first anniversary, we organized a special outfit illustration design contest in which players could submit custom designs which would be turned into a special in-game illustration. And the winning submission was by Harriet at Rimuru Shion, which created this custom outfit for Rimuru, and they called it the Sky Flying Skating Slime. So, without further ado, let's have a look how this turned out, because that's a very unique design. We love the little pads of Rimuru and a very nice helmet, but what does that mean for the actual design? Ooh. And here we have the final design. It turned out so great. We see the little details on the skates, and then obviously the little pads that they have on the knees, as well as the helmet. It looks super cute. It's very dynamic also. I love the bright colors. Everything really puts together. So I can't wait to see this in game. And congrats again to Harriet for winning. Now, this is already it for today's episode, so let's head to the outro. And that was it for today's episode. I hope you guys are excited. I'm very excited to see Momiji in the game because she looks super cute. And also the other outfits look super cool, and Benimara and Alice. And I also hope you guys are excited to finally see that awesome design that was created for the contest, the design contest, now as an in-game illustration. Super well done. And also, I hope you guys have been just in generally enjoying the latest updates, got some quality of life improvements. And also, we have some exciting new video content coming to you soon with me, which you'll see very soon, so keep an eye for that. And as usual, make sure to follow us on our social media channels to give us feedback and just to hang out with us. And see you guys in the next episode. So have a nice day and see you guys later. Bye bye. Have a nice day.